हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिस्टर परीक्षित राणा, योर इंग्लिश टीचर। वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल इंग्लिश संस्कृत ई लर्निंग। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अ न्यू पोएम, पोएम नंबर 4, अ थिंग ऑफ ब्यूटी, रिटन बाय जॉन किट्स। समथिंग अबाउट पोएट जॉन किट्स। जॉन किट्स वॉज बॉर्न इन लंडन in the year 1795 and died in Rome in 1821 at the young age of 25 due to illness. He is a romantic poet and his poetry is characterized by sensual imagery in his most popular work, which is a series of odes, a lyrical poem which is meant for a particular subject. This poem is an excerpt from his poem Endymion, a poetic romance, 1818, considered to be an epic poem. The poem A Thing of Beauty is based on Greek mythology about a shepherd named Endymion, his quest for his love Diana, and how in his quest he falls in love with an earthly maiden who later turns out to be Diana herself. So look here, this is the first stanza of the poem. Friends, in this world, most of the people are living miserable life in spite of having everything with them. So poet says that people always remain sad. So through this poem, poet wants to convey that there are the beautiful things in this world which gives us joy forever. So in the first line, poet says that a thing of beauty is a joy forever. Poet says that all the things which is full of beauty, it is full of joy forever. Its loveliness increases. The loveliness of the beauty is continuously increases. It will never pass into nothingness. Means it never goes off, but will keep a bower quiet for us and sleep, full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. Bower means a shady place under the tree. So poet says that a thing of beauty is a shady tree, under whose shade we all the creatures, we all the human beings can sleep, enjoy good health, and we can breathe freely. Therefore, on every morrow means on every tomorrow. Here morrow means the following day. Are we wreathing a flower band to bind us to the earth? So poet says that every day or the following day, it is the beauty which fills us with the spirit to live. Spite of despondence. Spite of means here in spite of. Despondence, it means depressed or sadness. So in spite of having sadness. Of the inhuman dearth. Dearth means lack. So inhuman, not a human. The behavior of the cruel behavior of the human, of noble nature, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over darkened ways made for our searching. Yes, in spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the pall from our dark spirits. So the meaning of these lines, poet wants to say that we are bound to the beauties of the earth. We are bound to the beauties of the earth, and without beauty the earth is full of gloom and sadness. So poet says that in spite of all sufferings, these beautiful things remove the cover of sad feelings from heart. Okay, pall means cover or covering the sad feelings from our heart. Poet says that, further he says that this beauty will desire to leave us among cruel people. So poet wants to say that without beauty this earth is full of inhuman dirt, means cruel people. It is the beauty which removes the sadness and darkness from our mind and soul. Such the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon for simple sheep, and such are daffodils. Daffodils is a name of flower. With the green world they live in, and clear rills that for themselves a cooling covert make against the hot season, the mid forest break. So in this stanza, in this line, poet describe the different beautiful elements of nature. All those elements are like a boon for us. Poet says that. Poet here describes the beautiful elements of nature like sun, moon, trees, flowers, rivers, etc. Poet says that all these things are like blessings. Trees provide us with their shade, flowers with their beauty, rivers with coolness during the hot season. All these beautiful things of nature are like a boon for us. Rich with a sprinkling of fair musk rose blooms, and such too is the grandeur of dooms we have imagined for the mighty dead, or lovely tales that we have heard or read, and an endless fountain of immortal drink pouring unto us from the heaven's brink. The first two lines. Rich with a sprinkling of fair musk rose blooms, and such too is the grandeur of the dooms. Poet further describes the beautiful things of nature. Poet says that beautiful musk roses have nice fragrance. Okay, now next two lines. We have imagined for the mighty dead all lovely tales that we have heard or read. Poet described the tales of the mighty warriors who sacrificed their life for their nation and humanity. Now last two lines. An endless fountain of immortal drink pouring unto us from the heaven's brink. In last two lines, poet says that these beautiful things of nature are immortal in this earth. These things are God's gift. The beautiful things are like nectar which help us to live further life. So friends, thank you very much for listening this video. Next poem we will discuss in next period.